So we are going to take you now to Brisbane, where Queensland Police Assistant Commissioner Roger Lowe is giving more details about Joel Cauchi, who, as mentioned, was shot dead at the scene yesterday.
Good afternoon. I'm Acting Assistant Commissioner Roger Lowe of the Security and Counter-Terrorism Command of the Queensland Police Service. So we've called the press conference today to assist yourselves and the media and the public in an understanding of the Queensland Police Service role in assisting the New South Wales Police Force investigation into the horrific crimes that have occurred in Bondi overnight. Certainly, our organisation expresses our thoughts and condolences with the family and friends of the victims involved in this horrific tragedy. It would have been extremely confronting for everyone, including our first response officers and those persons in the shopping centre during this event and those who have attended the scene. The information we have from the intelligence we have in Queensland, which we have shared with New South Wales Police in a cooperative manner, is that the person involved in the horrific crime has acted alone and there's no ongoing threat to our community. We have worked closely with the New South Wales Police Service yesterday evening, overnight and today to share information and intelligence and assist with the investigations so that the New South Wales Police can undertake their complex investigations into this event, certainly in the preparation for a coronial brief for the New South Wales State Coroner. We understand that these investigations take time and the success is dependent on the cooperation of all agencies involved to share the intelligence, particularly where this individual has been a resident of Queensland and is considered a person from Queensland. He's a 40-year-old man, as you're aware, and certainly the name has been released. He is a person whom has been identified as being known to the Queensland Police Service. In that regard, whilst the investigations are in their infancy and we're still conducting thorough investigations to assist New South Wales, I can say that the man has never been arrested by police in Queensland, nor has he been charged with any criminal offence. He has been in contact with the police, primarily in the last 4 to 5 years would be the most contact we have had with him. During that contact, we are aware that this individual has suffered from mental health. We are liaising with this man's family in Queensland, and we have spent yesterday evening, last night and today with the family in delivering the message regarding their son and assisting them with regards to providing information to the New South Wales Police Force. The family have cooperated with the Queensland Police Service in this regard, and they are issuing a statement on their behalf with respect to their own condolences and thoughts to the family and friends of those victims involved in this tragedy. Equally, they have sent a message to the New South Wales Police Force with respect to support of the police officer who has killed their son and expressing their concerns for her welfare. As you can appreciate, this is a major investigation and in response to when the Bondi event occurred, the Queensland Police Service and the Commissioner and Deputy Commissioner considered the safety of Queensland in the first instance. And we can change our posture in the community in terms of an increased police presence in shopping centres to ensure that Queenslanders are safe and Queenslanders feel safe. And we'll continue to increase that police presence to make sure the community understands they are supported and we are there to make sure they are safe. In saying that, we have no intelligence or concerns of an increased threat environment within shopping centres or the general public within the Queensland environment. But as a precaution, we certainly have increased our footprint. And we'll continue to do so to make sure that Queenslanders are kept safe. Do you have any questions?
What was his last known address in Queensland and where has he lived here?
So from the contact with the family, I can say this gentleman has been an itinerant over the last few years. He has moved from Brisbane, Kangaroo Point, Carina, and back to his family's residence in the Southern Police region.
What was the nature of the last interaction QPS had with this man?
The last interaction we had with this gentleman, this man, the offender in this instance, was in December 2023, where he was street checked on the Gold Coast. There is no interaction since December 2023 with this gentleman, and from our understanding in speaking to the family, he has been itinerant and has moved to New South Wales. We believe he has been sleeping in a vehicle or backpacks, according to the family's information, understanding that the family do not have regular contact with their son. It is periodic contact where he may respond to a text message.
And you said street checked. What do you mean by that? Was he checked over for a weapon or something on the street in 2023?
So street check is an intelligence gathering report undertaken by the Queensland Police Service when we may come in contact with a person that we deem sufficient to stop and speak to them regarding their behaviour or where they may be in a certain precinct. So, for example, street check is a way of recording wanding, where we may undertake wanding that we have the powers to do so in the safe night precincts or the transit hubs or on public transport. It's recorded as a street check wanding. So a street check is an intelligence gathering record by the Queensland Police Service where we may have contact with an individual and the police, through their Q-light devices in their possession, can record that interaction with people.
So he would have been displaying some kind of unusual behaviour to have that happen?
Street checks can be recorded for a number of different reasons in respect to contact.
You've said that previous interactions indicate that this man has had mental health issues. Can you walk us through in detail what has given it away to Queensland Police that he has mental health issues? Has he been calling in police to come visit him, or has he acted out in any way or injured anyone? Like, what gave it away for police that he has mental health issues?
So as you can appreciate, this investigation is for the State Coroner of Queensland, and the Queensland Police Service is compiling all the information and intelligence and records we have with respect to our interactions with this person who has committed this crime. In that regard, we will compile all that information for the coroner. We will share and have shared that with the New South Wales Police. So we are still in the process, in the infancy of preparing all that material for the New South Wales Police Force.
There are media outlets reporting that he had a history of domestic violence here in Queensland. Is that correct?
He has not been prosecuted or arrested or charged for any offence within Queensland, and he has no record within the courts for a domestic violence order.
What about outside of the courts or outside of actual charges? Has he ever been accused of it or had any sort of orders put in place against him?
So there's no orders in place.
When he was street checked in December, was the police officers find him with a knife, or has he been discovered with a knife on previous occasions?
So as you can appreciate, under Queensland law, it is an offence to have in your possession a knife in a public place without reasonable excuse. And the Jack's Law of wanding legislation allows us, in certain circumstances, to use the metal detection device to undertake wanding to search persons. In this regard, if we were to find a person in possession of a knife without reasonable excuse, there's likely to be a prosecution. And we know that 1,400 people have been charged with 2,500 offences linked to wanding and Jack's Law in Queensland in the last 12 months. In this regard, the person who is subject to the investigations of committing this crime has not been prosecuted for any criminal offence or not been charged with any offence in Queensland and not been found in possession of knives.
In the case
at the street checks we're talking about.
In the case that he's never been prosecuted or charged, but police were aware that he had mental health issues, when he went down to live in Sydney, would there be any reason that Queensland Police would have to keep track of this person considering he had these mental health issues, or is that not the job of QPS?
So the State Coroner will look at the interactions not only with Queensland Police but all other agencies, and that's expected in this type of investigation. The public expects the police and coroner to look at, was this event preventable? Is there any systemic issues that would have contributed to this? So those are in any coronial investigation, and they will form part of the information exchange we will have New South Wales Police. And New South Wales Police will travel up here in the very near future to obviously speak to the family as part of their investigation. We have people in our society who suffer from mental health. They go about their days without trouble, without causing these type of crimes. Mental health in society is not a crime, and we do not run an intelligence regime on persons who suffer from mental health. There'd only be an exchange of information if a person were to present such a security risk in society that we would need to monitor that behaviour. Understanding under the developments in intelligence gathering with the national criminal intelligence system within Australian jurisdictions, information and intelligence is accessible to all states through the NCIS, National and Criminal Intelligence System. So New South Wales Police and Victoria Police, where necessary, can access intelligence or information regards an individual in Queensland should they need to.
How is the family doing? Obviously, their son has committed this horrific act, but he's also died. So it must be incredibly tumultuous for them.
Look, it's a difficult time to tell anyone they've lost their son. Their first thoughts for us were to express their concerns regarding the family and victims of these crimes, and in particular their thoughts around the police officer who had to bravely act in such a manner. So they've issued a public statement with respect to that. They're assisting us in all elements that they can to gain an understanding of why their son in this particular case allegedly behaved in this manner and killed people in a public place. And that's really to the crux of the investigation New South Wales Police Service will look at. Why would a person behave and act in such a manner? And the coroner will look at how could this be prevented in the future. At the end of the day, this is not the society we want to live in, and anything we can do from the court's agencies to prevent this type of behaviour, we will.
So last interaction was December 23. It's been reported that the family came forward to police asking if their son was involved. Do you know if that was Queensland Police or New South Wales Police that happened?
I can say that the family, when viewed footage of the event on TV, believe that may well have been their son, and they reached out to authorities.
And is that because they had concerns that he was capable or he had been displaying some kinds of concerning behaviour?
They saw the footage and believed it may well have been their son, so they reached out to assist authorities during the evening.
Have any of the interactions with Queensland Police been related to...
All right, we're going to pull out of that press conference to now. That was Queensland Assistant Commissioner Roger Lowe speaking from Brisbane with more details on the Bondi attacker, who we now know is Joel Cauchi, who was from Queensland. He had moved to New South Wales, we understand, in just the last month. And as we just heard, he had a history of mental health issues. He has no criminal record, but was, in fact, known to police. Police had, in fact, had some interaction with him on the Gold Coast in December 2023. His family have described the 40-year-old as an itinerant. The family says he had been sleeping rough. They had only had contact with him periodically.